ladies and gentlemen, Sandy Patty.
Open your hearts. You know, the Bible does tell us that if we don't stop and praise the Lord is going to be praised anyway. So let's just tell the rocks and the hills that they can take the night off tonight. Because we are here to lift up the name of Jesus Christ. Do you believe that he's alive and well tonight? Yes, he is. Yes, he is. We are here to celebrate tonight. We're here to celebrate the King. And we're here to celebrate the kingdom. It's not just a kingdom that's way out there somewhere. Jesus says the kingdom of God is within you. When others see with earthly eyes just what they want to see, you will see the things that never die. You will know and recognize by simple, childlike faith the priceless truth that others will deny. And Jesus says this to us. When others say I'm just a man who liked to dream his dreams, and when others call a miracle a myth, you listen for eternity. In moments as they pass, and you see with spirit eyes what others miss. Upon this rock I'll build my kingdom, and on this rock forever and ever it shall stand, and all the powers of hell itself shall nevermore prevail. It is really a joy for us to be able to share this evening with you. Thank you so much for being a part of it. And it's also a joy for me to have First Call over here with me. Yay!
Amen.
Thank you. And it's equally as wonderful to have Mr. Dick Tunney sitting over here at the piano. Well, we hope that throughout the evening that we all can feel at home with each other because we all are a part of the same family. And we hope that we all can be challenged to a deeper walk with the Lord tonight. And that we can be of encouragement to one another, so that we can better learn how to love and understand each other. Wouldn't that be great? There are a lot of ways that we have found to say, I love you. We might say, je t'aime, or te amo, ya ti vi a liu blu. Ani o hevet o fa. Or we can say, I love you. Well, the sounds are all as different as the lands from which they came. And though our words are all unique, our hearts are still the same. Love in any language, straight from the heart, pulls us all together, never apart. And once we young are differences, yet look how we're the same. We love to laugh, we dream our dreams, we know the sting of pain. From Leningrad to Lexington, the farmer loves his land, and daddies all get misty-eyed to give their daughters hands. You know, tonight we have come here, like that song says, from different languages and backgrounds, beliefs, denominations. But that really doesn't matter tonight. It doesn't even matter if we agree about everything. What's important is to know that if we serve the same Lord and Savior, and that's Jesus Christ, then we are undivided.
We may worship different ways. We may praise Him and yet spend all of our days living life divided, divided.
But when we seek Him with open hearts, He
glad you all are here tonight. I know I certainly am. You know, for about the last 7 years, I have been all by myself up here on this platform, so it is really nice for me to have company. And I would rather sing with no group of people than these guys standing right here, and that is the truth. But when we first started talking about these guys coming on the road with us, they said, well, you got to know something here up front. We are very committed to our families. And I liked hearing that very, very much. They said, but unless we can bring our husbands and our wives and our kids and our dogs and our cats on the road with us, we're not really interested in coming. And so we kind of worked that all out, and our families are all with us. I have to tell you, it makes for a very interesting backstage. We just want you to get a peek at our interesting backstage here a minute. Come here. Can you tell everybody what your name is? What's your name? Her name is Anna. This is my little girl, Anna, who is 2 years old. I can't believe it. And this is Bonnie's little girl, Courtney, who is 2 and a half. Courtney, can you wave at everybody? Can you wave at everybody? And these are Marty's two boys. This is Ben here, who is 4 years old. And this is Peter, who turned 1 years old in, where was that? Where did he turn 1 years old? Somewhere down in Kansas City? Kansas City, he turned 1 year old. We had a great party. Now, Dick and Melody did not want to be left out here. So 4 very short months ago, this little pumpkin was born. She's awake and everything. Now, I have to tell you, I have seen some proud daddies in my day. But next to my husband, John, this guy, look at this face. I'm telling you what, is that a proud dad? Okay, I know you are dying to give the people the whole scoop, so her name is?
Her name is Whitney Lane.
Whitney Lane. That's a nice name. You all did very good. She was born
on February the 4th.
February the 4th, right here in Nashville, Tennessee. Well, I tell you, little Whitney is just a true.
She was 7 pounds and 4 ounces.
Thank you so much for sharing that with us. But I tell you, she has just
adapted. She was also 19 and a half inches long.
She have a social security number yet?
Well, not yet, but I don't know if you can see these all the way in the back of the balcony, but little snapshots from the home.
Would you give our backstage a nice hand? Keeps reaching to the people of every land, a love that is longing to fill the heart of salvation, a hope that is always glowing bright. It scatters the darkness swept away by his mighty hand. Now all the nations can worship, sing the song of that glorious land. Shine down your light on me, let the debating all afternoon as to what to do on this next song, because I guess, you know, these guys are great and everything, but they're just, you guys aren't going to work on this next song. I'm really sorry. No, wait, don't go away. I need the help of some of the kids in the audience. So could, if everybody, you know, let's say maybe from 12 and under, if you all could just hurry on up here on the stage, I want you to help me on this song. If you're in the balcony, it's going to take you a little longer to come down, so you better start coming now. We'll just fill up as much space as we can. So just keep coming. Oh my goodness. This is going to be so much fun, I can tell. Here they come from the balcony. Come on down. I sound like Bob Barker here, don't I? Come on down. Now, believe it or not, I need you all to help me with some actions on this song, okay? Now, all we're going to do is we're going to sway back and forth, right, left. But you see, it's real important. It's so important. It's very important that we start in the same direction. So we're going to start to the right. And what we're going to do is this, just right, left, right, left. Do it with me. Right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, and stop. Okay? Now that's all there is to that part of the song, okay? So when I say to the right, we're going to start that way, okay? Now, we're going to get to another part of the song, and I'm going to tell you to bow your head. So let's practice that one time. Come on, everybody, bow your head. Bow your head. Bow your head, no peeking. Then I'll say lift up your head, so lift up your head. And then lift up your hands. Go on, lift both hands way up, as high as you can reach. Come on, get them way up there. You got them up there? Then I'm going to tell you to stand like a soldier, and I want you to bring your hands down really fast and stand at attention. I mean as fast as you can without knocking your neighbor's head off. Okay? Let's practice that one time. Everybody put your hands up, both hands up. Come on, get them way up there. Now remember, I mean fast, like a soldier. Oh, now that's more like it. Very good. Oh, I can't believe I forgot to tell you, this is the most important thing in the whole song. Whenever you are up here on stage, you have to smile all the time, toothless or not. You have to smile all the time. Now I want you to listen real carefully. Here's what we're going to do. When I count to three, I want to hear you say, I got it. And I want you to say it so loud that the people all over this place can hear you. In fact, if they hear you, they are going to clap, all right? So you yell it out there. You don't have a microphone or anything, so you got to yell it. When I count to three, I got it. Ready? One, two, three! All right, now remember, don't forget what I told you now. Don't forget the smell. I mean smile, sorry. Listen to the purest praises as you hear the little children sing. We are children of all ages. Join our voices as we praise the King. Song of glory, song of celebration, singing gladly, Jesus we adore. Singing praises, echoing God's love. Song of glory, song of celebration. Singing gladly, Jesus we adore. Celebrating as a family. All God's children sing unto the Lord. To the right, sing. And the Lord, now your hands, is glorified. Like a soul. want you to take a bow. Come on, take a bow. Fantastic job, everybody. We have a great time as we travel across the country, and we get to see some very wonderful places in our world that God has created. About a year and a couple of months ago, we went to Israel along with Bill and Gloria Gaither and the Gaither Vocal Band and Larnell Harris, and we just had a great time. We did a couple of concerts together there, but spent most of our time sightseeing, as all good tourists do. But it was so much more than just sightseeing for me, because we were walking the places that Jesus had walked. And we were seeing the places that he had seen. And we took a boat out onto the Sea of Galilee. And we walked up that mountainside where he had given the Sermon on the Mount and fed the 5,000. And we went to the tomb where he is no longer. Amen. Amen. He is alive. But there was one place that kind of intrigued me a little bit. And all it was just a very simple road. It was a road that went from the heart of Jerusalem to Calvary. But it was that road that Christ walked after he had been sentenced to be crucified. That road is called the Way of Sorrows, the Way of Suffering. And the Spanish name for that road is the Via Dolorosa. And that means the Way of Sorrows. And I want you to do something with me. Over the next couple of songs, I want to take you on a journey that begins down the Via Dolorosa. Before that glorious Easter morning when we knew that Jesus Christ was alive, he chose to walk that road because he loved you, because he loved me.
In Jerusalem that day, the soldiers tried to clear that narrow street, but the crowd pressed in to see this man condemned to die on Calvary. He was bleeding from a beating. There were stripes upon his back, and he wore a crown of thorns upon his head, and he bore with every step the scorn of those who cried out for his death. Down the Via Dolorosa, called the Way of Suffering, all the way to Calvary. Por la Via Dolorosa, triste día en Jerusalén, los soldados le abrían paso a Jesús, mas la gente se acercaba para ver al que llevaba aquella cruz. Oh, Rabí, Dolorosa, que es la vía del dolor, como deja vino Cristo, Rey Señor. Y fue Él quien quiso ir por su amor, por ti y por la Via Dolorosa al Calvario y a morir. The blood that would cleanse,
the souls of all men made its way through the heart of Jerusalem. Down the Via Dolorosa, all the way of suffering, like the Lamb came the Messiah, Christ the King. But he chose to walk that road out of his love for you and me. Down the Via Dolorosa, all the way to Calvary. Ooh. Was it a morning like this, when the sun still hid from Jerusalem, and Mary rose from her bed to tend the Lord she thought was dead? Was it a morning like this, when Mary walked down from Jerusalem, and two stood at the tomb, bearers of news she would hear soon? Did the grass sing? Did the earth rejoice to feel you again? Over and over, like a trumpet underground, did the earth seem to count he is risen? Over and over, in an ever Was it a morning like this, when Peter and John ran from Jerusalem, and as they raced toward the tomb, beneath their feet was there a tune? Did the grass sing? Did the earth rejoice to feel you again? Over and over, like a trumpet underground, did the earth seem to pound he is risen? Over and over, in an never-ending round, he is risen. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Over and over, like a trumpet underground, did the earth seem Was it a morning like this, when my Lord looked out on Jerusalem? He is risen, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
They came to
to follow him, drawn by what he'd promised them, if they would sell all that they had. He said that God would send a kingdom that would never end, where all the poor would be so rich. And in their discontent, they heard what they thought he meant. They heard that the weak would be strong, bread would be multiplied, and hunger be satisfied, and every servant a king. Building what eyes can never see, while men looked for crowns and thrones, he walked with crowds alone, planting a seed in you. Yeah.
So
but I am having a great time tonight. I enjoy telling the Lord how much I love him through music. Music is a way that's very comfortable for me. And you know, I'm not the only one. I think a lot of people find a real comfort in music and singing praises to the Lord. Way back in King David's time, those psalms that we read, those were songs of praise to the Lord. And 25 or 50 or 100 years ago, the very dedicated men and women of God wrote some beautiful songs of praise to the Lord. And we call those hymns. Those hymns have really ministered to my life ever since I can remember. And they continue to do so. And we just want to kind of stop everything down a little bit tonight and share with you some of our favorite hymns. Now, if we happen to be singing one of yours, we sure would love for you to sing with us or hum along or pat your foot or whatever you want to do. But let's allow these hymns to be fresh to us tonight and let the words really speak to our hearts. This is one of my favorites. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. I'm an heir of salvation, a purchase of God, born of his spirit, and I've been washed in his blood. And you know, when we'd go to camp meeting, this song sounded a little like this. This is my story. This is my song. I'm praising my My grandma had so many favorite hymns, and there is one that I can still hear her singing around the house. Dick, would you play that? Thank you.
our sins and our griefs to bear. And what a privilege it is to carry everything to God in prayer. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see.
Those beautiful parts and sing the chorus with us. It is well.
It is well.
when I, in awesome wonder, consider all of the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder. This chorus, sing with me. Then sings my soul.
See.
is. Praise the Lord. And all of God's people said, amen. Amen. How truly great he is. Great is his faithfulness in our lives every day. Amen. I turn to God's word for those many promises. And the 23rd Psalm has been a source of strength to me these last few months. Because I want very much to be for the Lord to be my shepherd, to be my leader, to be my guide. And I found the 23rd Psalm in a book called Psalms Now by Leslie Brandt. And it really spoke to my heart. If it's okay, I just feel like this is maybe for somebody else besides me tonight. Will you let the word bring you strength and bring you power and bring you hope? The psalm starts out by saying, the Lord is my constant companion. There is no need that he cannot fulfill. Whether his course for me points to the mountaintops of glorious ecstasy or to the valleys of human suffering, he is by my side. He is ever present with me when I tread the dark streets of danger, and even when I flirt with death itself, he will not leave me. When the pain is severe, he is near to comfort. And when the burden is heavy, he is there to lean upon. When depression darkens my soul, he touches me with eternal joy. When I feel empty, and at times when I feel alone, he fills the aching vacuum with his power, so that my security rests in his promise to be near to me always, and in the knowledge that he will never let me go. Let's make this our prayer tonight.
Maker of this heart of mine, you know me very well. You understand my deepest part more than I know myself. So when I face the giants, and when I need to find my way, I'll trust in you, Shepherd of my heart. Keep heart of mine, your patience has no end. You've loved me back into your arms time and time again. So if I start to wander like a lamb that's gone astray, I'll trust in you, Shepherd of my heart. You're the beacon of my night. You're the sunlight of my days. I can rest within your arms. I can know your loving ways.
So let the cold winds blow and let the storms rage all around. I'll trust in you, Shepherd of my heart. You're the beacon of my nights. You're the sunlight of my days. I can rest within your arms. I can know your loving ways. So I'll be listening for my master's call, and I'll trust in you, Shepherd of my heart. I'll trust.
There is
Jesus, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess, and we shall be whole. We shall. Angels shall.